Hey, what's up, you guys? It's Caboose bringing you another Spider-Man PS4 video, and today is the day I can finally talk about the game I have been waiting 2 years to get my hands on. Today is the day I'm going to be giving you guys my non-spoiler review of Spider-Man PS4. Now, before we jump into the review, I must give a huge thank you to Sony Interactive Entertainment Canada for providing me with a review code of the game and allowing me a chance to play through it so that I can give you guys my detailed thoughts on it. So thank you once again to Sony Interactive Entertainment Canada for the review code. I got to play through it, and now I'm going to give you guys my non-spoiler review of Spider-Man PS4. Now, let's talk about it. Spider-Man PS4 is spectacular. Insomniac Games has put an incredible amount of passion into crafting their version of this character in a way that both stays true to the comic book roots of Spider-Man, but also creates something original that we haven't seen before from the web-slinger. Spidey has 8 years of experience on his belt when you start the game, and from the opening minutes, no time is wasted in making that apparent. You are immediately thrown into the action as you race to take down Kingpin in a thrilling infiltration of Fisk Tower, and it's the perfect way to give us a feel for the traversal and the combat in the game. After that first mission, you're going to have to complete a few small tasks until you are given everything you need to fully explore Spider-Man PS4's open world. The map is massive. You will find yourself endlessly swinging through the city as you pass by both iconic NYC landmarks and buildings that you might recognize from the larger Marvel universe. I'm sure the number one question on everyone's mind, though, is how is the web swinging? And to put it simply, it is near perfect. What I really enjoyed about the traversal in the game is that it's not completely bare bones. It's complex, and if you want to be moving as fast as possible, there's definitely some mastery stringing different traversal options together, alongside basic web swinging. There are times, though, where the momentum in your swing can be completely slowed down. It's hard to tell if this is a bug or something to do with the physics in the game, but where I found myself completely immersed while swinging through the city, I was ripped out of that immersion every now and then when one of my swings would just slow me down to a halt. When it comes to combat, though, in the game, I'd consider this to be the best combat showcase for Spider-Man that we've ever gotten in a Spidey game. As you begin to unlock and upgrade Spider-Man's gadgets and abilities, you'll notice that every single engagement in combat can be handled differently. Topping this with multiple different enemy types makes for very engaging fights where you must utilize Spidey's entire arsenal to come out on top. There is plenty to do in this city. As you progress through the story, you will begin to unlock a plethora of side activities that will definitely keep you busy for a long time, and it also helps that some, but not all of these activities aren't too tedious. You will then soon find out that through these various side objectives around the city, you will unlock tokens. These tokens can be spent to craft new gadgets for Spider-Man, upgrade said gadgets, as well as craft brand new costumes for Spidey. There are plenty of alternate costumes in the game that range from comic books, movies, and designs that are original created specifically for this game. It's super important to note that none of the suits in the game are locked behind any sort of paywall. Every suit, even the ones that you get from pre-ordering the game, can be earned through leveling up and spending the correct tokens to craft this. I felt this was something to definitely commend Insomniac Games for, as there easily could have been some annoying microtransaction system in place here, and having the chance to actually be able to level up and earn these suits gives you a consistent goal to work towards as you play through the game, as there are definitely going to be some suits you will immediately want to complete the required objectives to unlock. And although I feel like it goes without saying, I should mention that this game looks beautiful. It is so damn good looking. The graphics are incredible. Beginning to end, it looks so damn good, and you seamlessly transition from gameplay to cutscene like it's nothing. Although there are certain moments in the game where you will find yourself at a loading screen, they fill those loading screens with these cool screenshots of whatever suit you're wearing, and it looks so awesome. There are going to be a million times in this game where you're going to hit that share button on your PlayStation controller so that you can save a screenshot from a certain moment in the game and use it as like a desktop background or tweet it out or something, because I'm telling you, this game looks so good. I know there's been a lot of controversy surrounding whether or not there's been a supposed downgrade to the game. Trust me, there isn't. Beginning to end, you're gonna see how damn good this freaking game looks. Now, let's talk about the story of Spider-Man PS4. I'm not going to give you guys much info on what's going on in the story for the game, as there are plenty of videos on the channel of me detailing exactly that, but I did want to give you guys my overall thoughts on the story, and to get into that, the story is lengthy, and it's written extremely well. One of the things Insomniac Games wanted to emphasize was how important it was to tell a story from both the perspective of Spider-Man and Peter Parker. It's through this that you really care for side characters like Aunt May, Mary Jane Watson, and of course Miles Morales, and all these characters are interwoven perfectly into the story and aren't just thrown aside to get back into the Spidey action. But that said, the action set pieces are sensational. But what elevates them from being just cool action moments in the game to being key story moments that keep you invested are those down-to-earth parts of the game where we truly get a sense of what Peter Parker has to lose if he were to fail. Now, we all know, of course, that you get to play as Mary Jane, as she is a key character in the story. And to be honest, I found the parts where you got to play as MJ to be slightly repetitive. It seemed that I was doing the exact same thing every single time I got to play as her, and I appreciate her overall role in the story and that she isn't just another damsel in distress, but I was hoping to play as Mary Jane in multiple different scenarios rather than it always being stealth missions. Now, we also got a lot of villains in this game, and the villains are great. Seeing the Sinister Six was something any Spidey fan would be geeking out over, and one of my biggest worries when I got to try out the game at E3 was that the boss battles might be lackluster based on the fight I had with Shocker in that demo, but I was very wrong to worry about those boss battles, as the boss battles in Spider-Man PS4 are fantastic. It was also mentioned by, I believe, James Stevenson that the game will run you about 20 hours to complete, and that is roughly accurate, but if you throw in side missions, the side activities spread across the city, and of course the endless hours we're going to have free roaming, you'll come to find that you've played much longer than 20 hours. Overall, Spider-Man PS4 lives up to the hype. I had extremely high expectations for the game, and I am so happy to say that those expectations were met. While the game isn't perfect, and there are certainly some immersion-breaking bugs to fix, it is undeniably fun, and it's going to keep you entertained for many, many hours. I'm going to give Spider-Man PS4 a 9 out of 10. And that's that. I got a walkthrough coming later this week and tons of content planned for the game that I can't wait to share with you guys. And I hope you enjoyed my review. And of course, if you did enjoy, if you could leave a like rating on the video, it shows your support and I'd really appreciate it. I'm Caboose, and you can click on screen and make your way to one of the other videos on the channel, or you can click my logo to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Please follow me on Instagram and Twitter and like me on Facebook. Those links are in the description. Drop a like if you enjoyed, leave a comment if you have an opinion, and subscribe if you're new. See you guys later.
Sorry, Herman. You brought this on yourself. Literally.